coming up. I am officially done for the night. Heading home now.
So I guess now, looking toward the future, what's next? My CAPS internship is done, but a lot of people, especially at this point in life, are kind of contemplating what's next, and I'm no exception. For me, college wasn't the solution. So I decided that I was going to take a gap. This is something that I've kind of known that I wanted to do since about 10th grade, because I kind of want to really go out there and do the work that I've been preaching. I want to get real life experiences and really kind of learn from doing. I don't want to just sit in a class and get things talked to me. I want to do what I did during CAPS, but kind of continue that and in the real world. So thank you very much. So during a live broadcast, like such as ESPN, a lot of the time statistics and kind of hardcore facts that they need to know is just written down on the page in front of them. That's why you see them like shuffling papers and stuff like that. So that kind of information is on the desk in front of them. And the teleprompter, which was what you guys could see, was reflecting at the talent, which said wrap up. That is kind of sometimes usually an intro is written there or the sign off. But for kind of shows like that, where it's pretty open form, they're having a conversation in front of the camera, it's pretty much all improvised, where they have talking points, but they don't really have anything scripted too much. Yeah.
So what genre of film are you most interested in? Like music videos, dramatic stuff?
So right now I'm kind of tasting as much as I can to kind of find out exactly what it is I want to focus on, but I do on my YouTube channel have a couple of short films that I'm working on. One of them is kind of sci-fi, and the other one is, I guess, just a normal drama. Yeah, and I guess for genre, I do like sci-fi and kind of thriller a lot. That's something that I could see myself doing for sure. Yeah.
Related to that, which director, like cinematographer genre, has affected your editing most?
My editing. Okay. For me specifically, I like continuous editing that is almost invisible, but kind of helps push a story with its pace and rhythm, which is obviously the goal of any kind of editing. And I could throw some names, I doubt any of you would know them, but if anyone here has seen the movie Dunkirk?
Yeah.
Some of the editing in that is something that really inspired me. The editor for that movie won an Academy, the Oscar, but that kind of editing is really, really cool, and also the cinematography in that movie is honestly incredible in my eyes. Yeah.
What are you doing with your gap year?
On my gap year? So I'm traveling mostly, kind of like these two over here. Over the summer, I'm going to Hungary to work on a film set with my mom's cousin's wife. Yeah, it's a weird connection, but distant relative's roommate. I will be working on a film set there because I kind of want to get that real-life experience of being on a film set, which I've never done before. But I feel like once I'm there, you know, I can really gauge whether or not I want to do that for the rest of my life, so it's a good place to be. Later on, I'm going to the Dominican Republic for a couple months to teach. Hopefully make some videos, you know. By the way, stay up to date on my YouTube if you want. I'll be posting weekly videos on my gap year. Later on, I'm also, from February to May of next year, I'm going on tour with a choir through Eastern Europe, where we'll just be performing every day or so songs. Yeah.
So how do you balance, I mean, you do a pretty good job on stage, too. Is that something that you want to keep pursuing? I mean, it's good not to put all one's eggs in one basket, but do you also hope to, I mean, you're going to do some more theater after you leave here? I mean, where do you want to be behind that camera?
I guess I am a big part of the theater department here, and theater is something that I love. Being on stage is a big part of my identity and kind of fun for me. When I go into the TV industry, I don't really think of it as, you know, concrete. A piece of advice that my teacher here, Mr. Dalloff, gave me earlier in the year is don't think you're one thing. Don't, like, box yourself into a certain kind of job. Like, when I'm going into the TV industry, I'm going to stay flexible and kind of see what opportunities present themselves, because those are the opportunities that I can obviously grab. I'm not going to try to search for something that's not there for me. So I could obviously see myself being a director, an editor, a filmmaker behind the camera, but I guess you never know, especially with the film industry the way it is. I could end up in front of the camera, I guess, and that's not something I'm opposed to.
We're not opposed to being there either.
Any other questions? Yeah.
You can tell me, why not documentaries? Why sci-fi?
Baseball. I guess, I make documentaries right now. I guess I just wanted to kind of try other things. I want to really just do as much as possible from as many sides of the spectrum to kind of know what it is that I'm really meant for myself. Because if I were only to box myself in and do one thing, I wouldn't really, I guess, know what the other side of things was and if I would like that more.